Hello.
Hey.
And welcome to Marathon Recon, a mile-by-mile preview of the LA Marathon. I'm Martise Moore, the Run Faster Coach, and today we're running mile 7 of the 2018 LA Marathon, and I'm privileged to run with Joe. Joe is a first-time LA Marathon runner, and he is running for the charity Cure CMD, so we're actually going to find out more about that. So let's get started.
Cool.
All right, Joe, so
hey,
thanks for coming out. This is
your
first.
Thank you so much.
This is your first LA Marathon. Oh, my goodness.
This is my first. Hopefully, it doesn't become my last on the course.
No, hopefully not. So what made you decide to do it? Because you've lived in LA for a long time, right?
I've lived in LA for a long time. Honestly, I've always hated running,
uh-huh.
and so have always avoided it as much as possible.
Uh-huh.
And so now with the fundraising for my daughter,
uh-huh.
It's given me the motivation.
Okay, so are you talking about Cure CMD?
I am, yeah.
Okay, so tell us what CMD is.
So CMD is congenital muscular dystrophy,
uh-huh.
and there's several subtypes of it,
uh-huh.
and my daughter has one of them,
uh-huh.
and so Cure CMD is a place to go if you have that,
uh-huh.
and try and find some of the resources that you need. So,
okay. So first, let's just talk about this mile real quick. We started at Echo Park, and now we're gonna cross across Park. Let's hit the button here. Okay, and if you could tell us a little bit about what actually, like, explain more about CMD, like, what does it do and why we need a cure?
Yeah, so Cure CMD, I mean, congenital muscular dystrophy, it's really essentially, you know, when you think long ago, when you were growing up and you had muscular dystrophy in the Jerry Lewis telethon, it was uh-huh. always every Labor Day.
Uh-huh.
And
what does that do? Like, it does it keep you from being able to do certain things?
Yeah, really good question. It basically really affects your muscles,
mm-hmm.
and you know, we all carry fat,
uh-huh.
but in essence it turns our muscles though into fat.
Oh.
Calcium leaks out of the cell wall,
uh-huh.
and turns that muscle into fat. So a lot of kids with CMD, you uh-huh. know, suffer certainly respiratory and cardio problems, because you know, when you think about it, our heart's a muscle,
mm-hmm.
and all the muscles that surround our lungs to allow us to breathe, and mm-hmm. that we take for granted,
right?
And so there is not a cure on the horizon,
mm-hmm.
but you know, there's some small steps that can be taken to improve just really the quality of life.
Uh-huh.
And here we go across. And that's really important.
Mm-hmm.
And and there are some clinical trials that are occurring.
Mm-hmm.
And with any rare disease,
mm-hmm.
you know, progress is slow.
Mm-hmm.
But just like we're running here, we got to take these little baby steps to mm-hmm. finish our mile.
Uh-huh.
And we got to take these baby steps.
Here's another hill,
at some
guys.
Point. This is the true actual hill,
yes.
that we will be going up.
Yes.
Preparing myself there.
Yes, Joe is preparing himself mentally for this race because he's never done it before. And he's very curious about the actual course.
I gotta be that little train. I think I can.
Oh, you definitely yeah. can.
Si puedo. So,
you're going to use your daughter as motivation.
Totally. You know, and so.
And all the other kids.
With that, you know, I think, you know, going back to those little steps, you
uh-huh.
just got to always start somewhere
mm-hmm.
with anything.
So, how are you training? Like, are you training by yourself or with a group?
I'm training by myself.
Okay, just turning right here.
And, downloaded an app
uh-huh.
that had a schedule of
somebody's gonna be running with you.
Awesome. They're gonna be very slow.
That's okay. It is a marathon.
Totally.
So how's the app training going?
It's going well. I sprained my ankle a couple weeks ago. So healing from that, but it essentially kind of has you running like 3, 4, 5, 6 miles daily on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, rest Monday, Friday, and then as you start getting closer to the race on Saturdays, you do, you know, the longer run, 10 miles, 12.
Well, what's the longest you've done so far?
I was going for the 10 when I sprained the ankle.
Let's go fast. Trying to cross the street.
Woohoo! 1 second, we meet.
Okay.
Straight up?
Yeah.
And
we're
so.
We're on Sunset Boulevard right now. Go ahead.
That'll be nice. So, I think like 2 weeks before the race, you know, on a Saturday, you're doing 20 miles and then, you know, back to the smaller miles on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday in anticipation.
So did you ever dream you could run that far? Like you said before that you didn't really like running. Prior to training for this marathon, what's the farthest you ran?
Ironically, you know, kind of jokingly, I don't like running, but did a couple like half marathons.
Okay.
There's that LA rock and roll marathon.
Oh, okay,
half
yeah,
marathon.
Fun.
That was fun. The music kind of kept you going. And but in general, like day to day, aside from those things, never ran. And even with those, kind of ran it cold and paid the price the next day.
Yeah, but you did.
So so does that seem like a good schedule?
Yeah.
Tuesday from you as a runner.
Yes.
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays, Saturdays.
And definitely getting your long run in.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's probably the most important part is so your body's not in shock when you do this really long distance. And I would also make sure you're including hills in your long runs or even your short runs too, because the LA Marathon is hilly. Okay, it's not a flat course, it's not a track, so.
Which is funny, because you think, like with LA, you know, it's, you know, you think sea level, so it should be this flat course.
Nope.
And
you see right now we're running downhill.
Yeah.
So this is your nice reprieve after running all that uphill. But guess what, there's gonna be uphill again. So yeah. Like you're riding around in your car and everything seems flat until you run it.
Yeah, you know, you take for granted this, even like this incline when I'm looking down Sunset, and if we were coming back up, it, you know, you'd definitely be at a angle going up. So yeah, so I'm a little nervous, but definitely have the motivation to just keep powering through. I'm a believer of a lot of mind over body. A friend of mine in college was a cross-country runner for a college, and he always, I still remember him saying that his body could do it, you know, with the proper training, of course, obviously. But that he was more always focused on training his brain, his mind.
Right, very good.
To say, I can do this.
Right.
And not let his mind tell him, oh, you're gonna tear out. Because he knew his body could do it.
Right.
And
Your mind, yeah, is gonna give up on you.
Yeah, so.
And so that's a really good point, because you wanna be training your mind during your training.
Totally.
Don't wait till a marathon to be like, oh yeah, let me get focused.
Yeah.
No, it's like building a muscle. Okay? It takes time. So you need to be practicing the mental and physical aspect of the race, because it's going to challenge both. And if you just wait till the day of the race, it's going to be a lot harder than when, you know, if you have been training this whole time. Your body already has the habit built in. So it's going to be, you know, a lot easier. There's nothing easy about this race, you know.
Yeah.
It really is going to test your self-imposed limits. So mentally, you know, you can have a huge advantage if you start, yeah, being more mentally tough. So can you give us an example of something you say to yourself to, like, push through the pain?
You know, it's funny. Thinking of that pushing through, when you were talking about that, a funny story happened where I was hiking, doing the Mount Whitney, and it's 14,000 feet, and you start at 3 in the morning, and you get up there about 11, and I felt like I had hit the wall, and we're only like 200 feet from the peak, and I kind of say, like, well, let's just pack it in, let's go back. And one of the friends I was with, she was like, you've got to be kidding. We're 200 feet.
Right?
Like, we're not turning back. Dig deep, Joe, dig deep. And that was a good lesson,
right,
to realize, like, wow, yeah, I mean, you are really, like, so close. And so kind of tying that in again to the, you know, the mental aspect, that, yeah, just stay focused. Like, okay,
take, you know, it there 1 mile at a time.
Yeah, I'm there 200 feet left. Don't quit. Okay, right. So I'm at mile 5. Okay, I'm, you know, about a fifth of the way done. Okay, at mile 15, I'm past that halfway mark. So just kind of plotting your, you know, self to, yeah, pacing it. Okay, mile 20, I'm getting really, I'm on the back stretch. Okay, I'm not just starting out, and even if it will feel like I'm, you know, my feet are lead, but again, kind of tying that into the mental, and I might be totally wrong on this. Martise will, at mile 20, they'll be scraping me, but off the floor. But hopefully I can say, okay, there's 6.2 miles left.
Yeah, that's just a 10K.
And it's a 10K, so you start breaking it down. And
you're basically compartmentalizing the race.
Compartmentalizing, that's a good way.
And that's a really smart way to go about it, because then it doesn't seem so overwhelming. So that's what I'm saying, like, definitely take it mile by mile, and you know, take get some motivation from the other runners too. You know, you're not in it alone. You're out there with 25,000 other people.
Totally.
So you know, use that energy to keep going, keep pushing. There's a lot of other people gonna be struggling out there with you, but they're gonna keep going too.
And not to be tying it kind of back to the CMD, not to be sounding sentimental, but you know, my daughter's in a wheelchair. So many people are with CMD,
right,
are in wheelchairs.
Right.
The choice of even being able to run, let alone walk,
right,
isn't even an option.
Right.
You know, so to be, for me, I feel very grateful and humble to say, wow,
yes,
at least I'm in an option,
yes,
where I can run.
Yeah, and that's a great motivator, because a lot of times we can do things for other people that we can't seem to do for ourselves.
Yeah.
So whatever you need to use for motivation, use it. And so yeah, think about those people who can't do it, who don't have the opportunity to train or even try to run this marathon, as a way to keep going. So
yeah,
you are trying to raise money for this charity, right?
Totally.
Okay, so we're gonna
CrowdRise.
We're gonna put your CrowdRise link up with the video, and so hopefully you guys can donate and help find a cure for this disease. So so we can help some more people get back out there and run. And if any of you have any questions about Mile 7 or any other aspect of the LA Marathon, please go to greenrunnerla.com. And until next time, keep running, everybody.
Woohoo! Awesome, you guys. Thank you.